God's name is Yahuwah, or Yahweh. Jesus' name is Yahusha, or Yeshua. The Holy Spirit's name is Ruach-Kodesh. Dad, again, we thank you for the privilege to kneel before you and pray. We thank you first for your Son, Yahusha, and Ruach-Kodesh, your Holy Spirit. We thank you for allowing us to be kingdom citizens. We thank you for your teachings and for all your visitations in the name of Yahusha, I pray. Thank you. Welcome to you, and I praise Yahuwah God for you. Let's begin. You've got to stand. Chapter 1. Do you have the boldness to stand in front of whatever enemy you are facing, to whatever enemy you will face this year? Whether the enemy is the devil himself, whether it is sin, whether it is financial debt, or whether it is illness, whatever you are facing, whatever you will face, do you have the boldness to stand? Stand up to it. Stand up against it. There comes a time when you have to have some aggression, some tenacity, some might about you, and we have to stand up and fight back, no matter what is happening to you, no matter how hard the fight is. As long as you keep fighting, you will win. The devil only wins if you let him. Life will only win if you let it. Fight on. Fight on. Fight on. Don't tell me you can't fight anymore. Don't tell me you can't fight anymore. Don't tell me I'm tired and alone. After all you have been through, you've got to stand. You've got to stand. Stand in the middle of heartache. Stand in the middle of calamity. Stand in the middle of restore. Stand in the middle of chaos. Stand in the middle of failure. Stand firm in the name of Yahushua Christ. Whatever it is, it will not defeat you. If it is an illness, fight back against it. It will not win. It will not win. The devil and his army can't stop what God has ordained for you in 2021. You will experience blessings of the Lord Yahuwah, the Most High, this year. The crown of favor is on your head. God will open doors for you. But your duty, your responsibility is to be as bold as a lion. Look at the ones who have gone before you. Moses, described in the Bible as the meekest ever, yet Moses had the boldness to go face to face with the most powerful man on earth at that time. And he told him, "Let my people go." Boldness. The great soldier, Joshua, who took the sword and led the children of Israel to conquer kingdom after kingdom after kingdom after kingdom. Boldness. King David, who slayed a lion, a bear, and a giant as a small boy. Boldness. You can't be bold if you see yourself as a victim. You can't be bold if you see yourself as a loser. You can't be bold if you see yourself as a coward. This is the year you realize you have the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob on your side. And he has equipped you, and he has fashioned you, and he has shaped you to be more than a conqueror. This is the year for you to walk in boldness. God's angels will protect you. His angels will minister to you. They will walk with you. The Holy Spirit will dwell inside you and will guide you. Victory will follow you. The crown of favor is upon your head. God has favored you. God has invested the blood of Yahushua in you. You have royal blood running through your veins. This year is the year when you will finally take a stand in the name of Yahushua. You are a child of God. Don't you dare let the devil dictate another year of your life. Let me just tell you about who God is. See, God, our God, is strategic. Our God is a methodical God. Everything he does is calculated. Nothing just happens. God is in complete control at all times. He knows the past, present, and future. Nothing, I mean nothing, catches him off guard. He is perfect in his planning. He is perfect in his timing. His ways are different from our ways. He has the capacity to create physical things from the invisible. That is the power to create something out of nothing, to create life where there is no life, with only his words. He can never be stranded or caught off guard or caught unaware. Even when he chooses to be silent over a matter, he has a plan to achieve, a plan to succeed. There are no mountains before God. They all become plains in his presence. He is the one who laid the foundations of the earth. Is there anything he cannot do? God is mighty in all battles. He does not have to fight before he wins. He is always the victor and never the loser. He does not have to fight before he wins. He does not have to fight before he wins. Did you hear that? He is always the victor, not the loser. He will always come out on top. No strategy, no ambush, no surprise attack will ever win against him. He knows all things, therefore he can win at all things. There is none more powerful than him. What an advantage, what a blessing that we have him leading our battles. The one who cannot lose. There are a number of things that can represent battle in the life of a man. Anything that afflicts, oppresses, discomforts, or maneuvers a man against his will or his wish, and causes him to be under perpetual pain and limitation, can be likened unto a battle. A battle is whatever a man struggles to take out of his life because it may be beyond his own power and ability. The battles that individuals are facing differ with varying degrees of intensity. Some people face the battle of sickness, barrenness, failure, delay, poverty, and the like thereof, while others are faced with more fierce spiritual battles beyond human understanding or explanation. The battle is the Lord's. He said, "Hearken ye, all Judah, and all ye inhabitants of Jerusalem, and thou King Jehoshaphat. Thus saith the Lord unto you, be not afraid nor dismayed by reason of this great multitude. For the battle is not yours, but God's." That's 2 Chronicles 20:15. Although both believers and unbelievers are faced with different kinds of battles, however, for believers, conflicts are stories that lead to victories. Tests are the mothers of testimonies. Trials can only end in triumphs, and problems problems are only ones with solutions. Why? Because they have God taking up their battles. See? They do not rely on their own power and strength, but the children of God rely on the power and strength of God. In 2 Chronicles 20, about three nations had risen against Judah with the intention of utterly defeating them in battle. King Jehoshaphat knew what to do by seeking the face of God. God's response to them was that of courage. The battle is not yours, but God's. 2 Chronicles 20:17. You will not need to fight in the battle. Position yourselves, stand still, and see the salvation of the Lord. Who is with you? Oh, Judah and Jerusalem, do not fear or be dismayed. Tomorrow go out against them, for the Lord is with you. As children of God, we should never be afraid. We should never be dismayed because the Lord is with us. Our salvation is found in God. He will help us fight the battle. God simply ordered the sum of the people of Judah to go into battle with singing and playing of music. They said, "Praise the Lord, His mercy endures forever," while the others waited to attack. What a strategic God! The hotter the battle, the lesser the effort of God in winning it. They were able to triumph over the army to win the battle. Let me read 2 Chronicles 20:18 and 19. As Jehoshaphat bowed his head with his face to the ground, and all Judah and the inhabitants of Jerusalem fell before the Lord, worshiping the Lord, and the Levites of the children of the Kohathites and of the children of the Korahites stood up to praise the Lord God of Israel with a loud voice on high. Please know, when God is with you, you don't have to live a life tormented with fear. We need to remind ourselves of the other name Yahushua was given by his heavenly Father, the name Emmanuel, because the name Emmanuel means God is with us. We, as the children of God, can live with the security of knowing that we are not alone. Listen, Yahushua said in John 14:27, "My peace I give to you, not as the world gives do I give to you. Let not your heart be troubled, neither let it be afraid." God is with you. Fear not, because of Isaiah 41:10. "For do not fear, for I am with you. Do not be dismayed, for I am your God. I will strengthen you and help you. I will uphold you with my righteous right hand." No matter what you are facing, fear not. God does not abandon his people. God does not abandon his people. Even before the coming of his Son, he was near his people. And he's near all of us in everything we face, in every storm we face. God is with us. In every grief we bear, God is with us. In every sorrow we face, God is with us. Who is bigger, your fears or God? So with God, there's no need to be fearful, regardless of what we are facing in this world. Do you have the boldness to stand in front of whatever enemy you are facing, to whatever enemy you will face this year? Whether the enemy is the devil himself, whether it's sin, whether it's financial debt, or whether it is illness, whatever you are facing, whatever you will face, stand up against it. there comes a time when you have to have some aggression, some tenacity, some might about you, and we have to stand up and fight back. No matter what is happening to you, no matter how hard the fight is, as long as you keep fighting, you will win. The devil only wins if you let him. Life only wins if you let it. Fight on, fight on, fight on. And again, don't tell me you can't fight anymore. Don't tell me you can't fight anymore. Don't tell me I'm tired and alone. After all you've been through, you've got to stand. You've got to stand. Stand in the middle of heartache. Stand in the middle of calamity. Stand in the middle of restore. Stand in the middle of chaos. Stand in the middle of failure. Stand. In the end, you will still be you. Be one that's done all the things you set out to do. Stand. There's a cross for you to bear. Things to go through if you're going anywhere. Stand for the things you know are right. It's the truth that's the truth makes Satan so uptight. Stand, all the things you want are real. You have you to complete, and there is no deal. Stand, you've been sitting much too long. There's a permanent crease in your right and wrong. Stand. There's a midget standing tall and a giant beside him about to fall. Stand, they will try to make you crawl when they know what Satan is saying makes no sense at all. Stand, don't you know you are free? Well, at least in your heart, if you want to be. Stand firm in the name of Yahushua Christ. Stand firm in the name of Jesus Christ. Whatever it is, it will not defeat you. It will not defeat you. It will not win. It will not win. It will not win. Remember, the devil only wins if you let him. Fight on. Fight on. Fight on. Stand, my brother. Stand, my sister. Whatever it is, it will not defeat you. It will not defeat you. It will not win. It will not win. James 5:13. This is a good place to stop today. I pray we have answered some questions for you today. We pray to see you tomorrow. Father, thank you very much for your word again today. Thank you for the listeners. Bless them all and all their families and their friends. Thank you, Lord. In the name of Yahushua, I pray.